guys, Mira here, back again for another video finally. Today we're here to talk about vitamin C, both how to select an effective formula for your skin type and your skin concerns. We'll also be discussing some of my favorites, who I recommend them for. It took me a little bit to finally get back on YouTube. I uploaded a few videos and then just kind of been kind of waiting for a little more time in my crazy hectic schedule to be able to film. And then the last week or two I have had time and I didn't. So I feel like the last week or two, I don't know if it's just the pressure I put on myself, but I've been stalling. So it's late at night, so excuse the lighting, and I'm just kind of wearing a comfy sweater that hopefully does not have too much cat hair on it. But I wanted no distractions and no excuses. I'm just sitting down and I'm filming this video. If you guys are in my Facebook group, which has over 11,000 members now, which is super cool, but I do weekly lives, and I think when you're doing a live video, it's a little bit easier. Because, you know, I'm talking to you guys and it's live and there's nothing I can do about any stuttering, where when I'm filming, I tend to like watch videos back and I'm super critical of myself. So I'm just trying to maybe just embrace the fact that I'm not a natural on camera. That's okay. And practice makes perfect. So I promise to be more consistent and I'm excited to do this video because it's a topic that I am excited to talk about. I love vitamin C and I think antioxidants are often not emphasized enough in skincare. Also, really quick, I did finally get approved for an Amazon store, which is really cool. I think it just helps to kind of make my recommendations a little bit more shoppable and accessible for you guys. So I'll link that in the description below and let's go ahead and get started. First up is a quick refresher on antioxidants. Antioxidants in skincare are used to supplement internal defenses, which when overwhelmed can result in oxidative stress and DNA damage. Okay, in talking about vitamin C in skincare, we kind of have to talk about the OG SkinCeuticals formula. You know, there is some earlier research technically, I think like Celex did some studies, but Dr. Pinnell, the founder of SkinCeuticals, did really the bulk of that original research and really paved the way for ascorbic acid formulations in skincare, and you gotta give the guy credit in the OG SkinCeuticals formula. So I do have a little mini here. I've used SkinCeuticals in the past, many years ago. I have like a box of little minis. I love having those on hand just to be able to kind of compare a lot of my affordable recommendations to the standard, right? That really, I think all ascorbic acid formulas should be compared against to determine if they are effective and staying stable. I will say though that all of the options that I'm gonna be talking about are more affordable, and I actually reached for them over this SkinCeuticals formula. But again, it's important because, you know, that research paved the way and really tells us what we need to look for when we're picking up an effective vitamin C formula. So the first thing you want to look for with ascorbic acid is a low pH, 3.5 or below. Personally, I prefer even lower, closer to a 3. The reason for that is because ascorbic acid is highly unstable and prone to oxidation. More importantly, if the pH is not low enough, it's not gonna get into the skin and penetrate past that skin barrier. It's water soluble, you know, water soluble ingredients tend to have a tough time getting into the skin. And they've shown that there's very low penetration if that pH is not low enough. The other thing that you want to look for is concentration. While we do have studies done with a 5 to 10%, 15 to 20% is the more proven concentration and what I personally recommend that you look for unless you're very sensitive or maybe new to vitamin C. But you do not want to use a concentration higher than 20%. There's no added benefit to using a higher concentration, only more irritation. And the other thing that I highly recommend looking for is other antioxidants. SkinCeuticals in particular has made popular that combination of ferulic acid, vitamin E, and ascorbic acid. And what we know about antioxidants in skincare is that they work synergistically together and really enhance photoprotection. So these three antioxidants in here separately only protect the skin so much, but when you combine them, you actually get eightfold protection, which is pretty incredible and shows that they work again synergistically together. The other thing is that the solubility, whether you know you have a water soluble, fat soluble, or an enzymatic antioxidant, determines how it protects the skin. You know, a fat soluble antioxidant will protect the skin much differently than a water soluble one. So if you get a wide array of antioxidants in there, you're gonna do a much better job of protecting the skin with sunscreen, of course. Now you may be wondering, what are the benefits of vitamin C in skincare products? And per the research, the main thing is gonna again be photoprotection. It's a very potent antioxidant, particularly combined with other antioxidants. But it does have additional benefits. They've shown that ascorbic acid is very helpful in helping kind of repair photo damaged skin. It can help stimulate collagen synthesis in the skin. The other thing is that ascorbic acid does have a mild exfoliating benefit. And also what's important is it's a mild pigment inhibitor. So if you have, you know, fairly mild hyperpigmentation, it can be helpful as well. Now that we've talked about, you know, really the research on vitamin C and kind of the standard here with the SkinCeuticals, what vitamin C does for the skin and what we should be looking for in a vitamin C formula, we can get started on my favorites, my recommendations. And I really like to stress, you guys, who products are good for, and I like to have a wide array of recommendations for a wide array of skin types. So just keep that in mind. But in general, when you're watching content, make sure that if someone is talking about a product that works for them personally, you have a similar skin type and similar goals before going out and buying that. Number one, I actually don't have here because I've been testing a bunch, but I'm gonna pop an image of it right here. It is the Skin Actives 20% Vitamin C Serum. The only reason I don't have it currently is I've been testing a bunch of other vitamin C formulas, and the Skin Actives I've used for years. That's why I think at least 4 years now. It's a fantastic formula. I really like it for, again, my normal to dry skin type. It's a little bit more hydrating. You have a nice amount of glycerin in there, other humectants, as well as some pomegranate oil. And this makes it both hydrating, but also it's not gonna be sticky or tacky on the skin. That's something I cannot stand in vitamin C formulas. The Skin Actives is also excellent because it is a pH around 3. That kind of balances, you know, good penetration with low irritation for ascorbic acid. And again, you've got 20%. It's in pump packaging, which I actually prefer to the SkinCeuticals. It's gonna help keep it stable for longer. And then they combine the ferulic acid and the vitamin E, just like the OG SkinCeuticals. Then they actually take it a step further and add a ton more antioxidants to this formula. So it's hydrating and it has a wide array of antioxidants in there for even better photo protection. It's also in a pump. It's about like $20, $25. Depending on whether or not you use a discount code. So it's incredibly affordable as well. And I really recommend it for dry skin, normal skin, as well as mature skin and people who have hyperpigmentation and need additional protection from the sun with sunscreen. Okay, the next vitamin C's I'm gonna talk about are both from Dermalore. I'm gonna talk about their original formula first. This is what I discovered first on Amazon. I was browsing Amazon, which I want to do because I am kind of all about finding affordable skincare finds, so I'm constantly researching and looking for not just affordable options, but really innovative, fantastic formulas that outperform other expensive options, right? So I found this original one on Amazon. It was like the end of December, and I was really surprised that no one was talking about it or had reviewed it, and I ended up ordering it, and it arrived December 1st. And the most impressive thing that I'm gonna say right away is the stability of this formula. Again, this arrived December 1st. I'm filming this at the end of April, so it's almost 5 months old. You can see there is oxidation. It's a little bit bubbly because I was trying to get the cap off. There is a for sure oxidation, but it's still completely usable, which is incredible for 5 months. So you can see when it gets to that burnt orange to brown color, you definitely don't want to be using that on your face. You can see this is, you know, oxidized, but still fully usable. And that is really impressive for an ascorbic acid formula that is 5 months old and in a dropper packaging. I think that is due to the very low pH in here. This is a pH of 1.9. In the original SkinCeuticals research, they did find that a pH of 2 penetrated the skin much more deeply than a pH of 2.5 or 3. However, I do want to say that there was some kind of variables in this research. They weren't sure if that was kind of an outlier, and the study was done on pig skin. So you have to take it with a huge grain of salt. However, regardless, that this very low pH makes this incredibly stable. It may also be due to the glutathione in here. Glutathione is a fantastic enzymatic antioxidant, and it actually works as an antioxidant pair with ascorbic acid, so they work really well together. The other thing too, though, is that ascorbic acid, as I mentioned before, oxidizes. However, this reaction is reversible, provided it only moves to the next step. So when the ascorbic acid becomes oxidized to DHA, the skin can actually reduce that back to ascorbic acid. Actually, I've done a study where they found that ascorbic acid and DHA together actually enhance penetration of the ascorbic acid into the skin. Then the skin was still able to use that DHA and reduce it back to ascorbic acid. So a little bit of oxidation in your formula might actually be beneficial. The issue comes when you move past the DHA. I'm so bad with pronunciation, you guys. I'm not even gonna try. It's too late tonight. Stick it on the screen here. Once it moves past the DHA, you move further along in that oxidation reaction, it becomes irreversible. It's not a reversible reaction any longer, and you don't want to be using that on your skin. This ingredient is also used in kind of tanning products, so it can make you orange. So again, that's why you don't want to be using a formula that is that rusty brown or really dark orange color. This also has the ferulic acid in here, which the ferulic acid and ascorbic acid alone have fourfold protection, and there is a good argument to be made for glutathione on these formulas. So it's a little twist on the original SkinCeuticals formula, but the stability and penetration is fantastic. The other thing is that this is a really light, non-sticky texture. So this has replaced the Timeless as my recommendation for normal to combo to oily skin. However, I'm dry and I can use this with a hydrator or, you know, a good moisturizer after, no problem. So it's not that it's drying. I just think that the light, nice light texture will make this very appealing if you are a little more oily. Dermalore then went ahead to release a new version, their Intensive Night Serum. The original formula, I bought it, and I started sharing it with you guys in December on Instagram, and Dermalore saw some of my content, reached out to me and said, we have a new release, would you like to test it? So this was sent to me. However, I'm not an affiliate, I make no money, it's not sponsored. And if I hated it, then I could have just said, you know, here's my feedback, I'm not gonna recommend it. Luckily, I don't hate this, I really like it. The pH compared to the original is a little bit higher. It's a pH 2.65. Honestly, that's still fantastic. You're still gonna get great penetration and stability. I would say the texture is just a little bit heavier. It's still not a heavy formula. I didn't find it sticky. That's due to the added active ingredients in here. This is a vitamin C and pigment inhibitor in one. They've doubled the glutathione and the ferulic acid, I believe. And then they've added azelaic acid, tranexamic acid, kojic acid, and mandelic acid, as well as, am I missing anything? The butyl resorcinol and alpha arbutin. So you have a nice wide array of pigment inhibitors. They're not a crazy high concentration, so this isn't going to be super irritating. I think this is a great vitamin C formula for someone who deals with hyperpigmentation or even acne and wants a daily vitamin C that's also going to be helpful for those concerns. You can also use it if you're someone like me who doesn't have a lot of melanin in the skin and who does chemical peels and wants something they can use as a prep the 2 weeks leading up to the peel, maybe doesn't need something super strong like a hydroquinone or something of that nature. So I've used this at nighttime to kind of address leftover acne marks, and I really enjoy this. I will say that if you're on the fence and you don't have hyperpigmentation, I would start with the original. This is kind of the OG that I really fell in love with first. I've tested this for longer and I really like this guy. It's a little bit more affordable as well. If you do have hyperpigmentation though, or if you want something that can double as a peel prep, then I would definitely check out the new one. I did get a couple questions, by the way, from you guys in the group asking if you can use this in the morning. Dermalore does market this as a night serum. That's why they call it the Intensive Night Serum. I will say though that I could not find any ingredients in here that were not photostable. Some ingredients, right, can be photosensitizing, like glycolic acid, meaning that they make your skin more sun sensitive. Those are fine to use in the morning because regardless of when you use them, they're still gonna make your skin more sensitive to the sun, and the answer is just to be really good with the sun protection. The issue can be is if an ingredient itself is not photostable. Think tretinoin, it degrades when exposed to light and air. And I could not find anything in the ingredient deck that was not photostable. So it should be fine to use in the morning as well. Is it if you're someone who wants a good vitamin C for the morning and you're dealing with hyperpigmentation, again, Dermalore does recommend it for nighttime. That's just what I have found kind of researching the ingredients and their photostability. And then the other vitamin C that I had to talk about in this video, even though I've been testing it for a dedicated Australian skincare video, along with some other products that'll cover European and UK kind of favorites. I just really want to be more inclusive of my followers, especially in my skincare group who are not in the US, but I tried this first from them and I have fallen in love with this. This is a fantastic vitamin C. It's a concentration of 20%. And again, they use that kind of OG SkinCeuticals formula where they have the ferulic acid, the vitamin E, and the ascorbic acid. Awesome thing about this one is, like the Skin Actives, it has a nice wide array of added antioxidants in there. So this has glutathione, fluorotin, it has alpha lipoic acid, and some other nice extracts and antioxidants in here. So it is super nice as far as photo protection goes. It's also got a little bit of a similar texture to the Skin Actives, where it's a little bit more milky. You can see it's not oxidized at all yet. However, this is a little bit lighter than the Skin Actives. The Skin Actives isn't heavy, again, but it's just very hydrating, and you can slightly feel that pomegranate oil when you first apply it. This is even lighter, and I will say that it feels a little bit more stingy and potent versus the Skin Actives. So this will, I think, work if you're normal to combo or dry, again, with a hydrator, or I think even oily skin might be able to wear this depending on what sunscreen or moisturizer you pair with it, if you go with something a little more mattifying. But I had to add this in here just because I think that the added antioxidants in here are fantastic. So if you are really focused on photo protection from the sun and other, you know, visible light and other factors that can cause oxidative stress and premature aging and all kinds of issues, this is fantastic. Okay, I had to mention one slightly pricier option. This is the IS Clinical, the Gene X Serum. This uses an encapsulated ascorbic acid, so it's very gentle. They've also combined it with the extra myzomes. Those are kind of focused on DNA repair and something that IS Clinical kind of specializes in. And you've also got the plankton extract in here. I wanted to mention this because, yes, it is a little pricier, so I would only recommend this if you are someone who really likes this brand, or, you know, who is a fan of professional skincare lines. This is good if you're looking for a vitamin C that you can use for nighttime. If you're focused on collagen production, repairing photo damage and hyperpigmentation that's due to sun damage, that's what I would recommend this for. I do prefer a vitamin C formula for morning, again, that has a nice array of antioxidants like this guy, right? Or the Skin Actives. I like to, again, have that wide array of antioxidants in the morning to really protect my skin from further damage. So this guy does not have that, so I don't recommend it for morning personally, unless maybe you're using a secondary antioxidant. However, if you are someone who has existing photo damage and you want an additional vitamin C product to really target photo damage, hyperpigmentation that's a result of sun damage, and you want in general kind of collagen synthesis, this is great. And again, it's encapsulated, so you can use this with a retinol type product. And there's good research for, you know, for general kind of anti-aging when you use a vitamin C with a retinol. So I wanted to just kind of recommend this. Again, all the other products are very affordable, but if you're a fan of Skin Beautiful RX, where you can get this, and as well as IS Clinicals as a brand and professional skincare, this is a good one. The last product I'm going to talk about is actually a C derivative. This is from Mugu Skincare. It's their 25% vitamin C and squalene. They are technically Australian as well, but they have a US site as well as a UK site, and I believe a Canadian site as well. So you can get this worldwide pretty much. The reason I wanted to talk about it though is because some people just cannot tolerate ascorbic acid, and I know that I will get a lot of questions about C derivatives. So if you would like a dedicated video on these vitamin C derivatives, please comment below and let me know, and I can definitely plan to do one. But research-wise, ascorbic acid is hands down more proven than any C derivative, and a lot of the obstacles with C derivatives is if they're able to be converted to ascorbic acid, because if they don't, if we don't have clear, compelling research showing that they become ascorbic acid, then they're useless to us. So if you can, whenever possible, use an ascorbic acid. However, if you're just simply too sensitive, then yes, you can use a C derivative, and the main ones that have the most research are going to be your magnesium ascorbyl phosphate. That's a C derivative that I recommend. Your goal is hyperpigmentation, and as well as kind of photoprotection and kind of stimulating collagen. Then we have the oil-soluble vitamin C derivatives, particularly tetrahexyl decyl ascorbate and ascorbyl tetraisopalmitate. That's quite a mouthful, I know. But I wanted to test out the ATIP because I read a really interesting blog post, which I'll try to remember to link in the description if I remember. She was talking about how THD and ATIP are not the same thing, despite a lot of the research and the manufacturers confusing them and implying that they are, that they are actually structural isomers. So she said that the research is actually more proven for ATIP. It's the better molecule. So I wanted to test it out. So I picked this up from Mugu, and anytime I wear this, you guys, in a live video or something like that, I always get comments on my skin. It really adds a nice glow. But more importantly, I think that with the vitamin E, it's a great product. The other thing though is that I have read a couple studies where they combined oil-soluble C derivative with ascorbic acid, and it greatly enhanced the penetration. So this has the vitamin E that the Dermalore is lacking. I mean, it has the glutathione instead, so I still think it's a great formula, but this has the vitamin E, and the ATIP, so it'll enhance penetration of the dermalure further. So if you were dry like me, this is such a good combo because you get the ascorbic acid, you get the glutathione and the ferulic acid, great formula. You get a little bit of added emollients and you enhance the penetration and add the missing vitamin E when you pair these together. So it's just an incredible combo with research kind of behind that to support it. You can get this by itself if you're sensitive and can't tolerate ascorbic acid. It's also just an amazing combination if you're a little bit extra like me about the photoprotection. Okay, you guys, it is super late. I'm gonna head to bed. I hope that was informative. I will definitely do more videos. I just wanted to kind of force myself to get a little bit back into the swing of things. Hopefully that was informative and helpful for you guys, and I will link everything as well as my Amazon storefront. I believe that the new Dermalure formula, this guy, might not be on Amazon yet. It might just be on their website. So if it is on Amazon by the time I upload this video, I will definitely make sure to add that to my Amazon store and link it down below. If it is not though, I will link it on their website. Give us a like or a comment if you want me to do more videos. You're welcome to request any content you'd like to see from me below. Really beyond thankful for you guys. I'm just super thankful for you all. Okay, I'm gonna get off and I will talk to you guys in the Facebook group, in the comments below, and I will be back on YouTube with another video very soon. Bye guys.